Good morning, students. Today we will start with the exercise 2.2 of polynomials. We already studied how to find out the zero of a polynomial and value of a polynomial. Okay, so we will start with the exercise 2.2. Take your class notebook, textbook, and do along. First question: find the value of the polynomial (5x - 4x²) + 3 at x = 0, at x = -1, and at x = 2. Okay, so this is your question. So find the value of the polynomial at x = 0, at x = -1, at x = 2. Okay, so first I will write the polynomial. Therefore, given p(x) = 5x - 4x² + 3. Okay, so we will find out the value of at x = 0. At x = 0, p(0) = wherever x is there, replace x by 0. That is 5 × 0 - 4 × 0² + 3. That is equal to 0 - 0 + 3. Therefore, the value of at x = 0 = 3. So you got the value of p(0) = 3. Okay, clear? Same way, you can find out the value of at x = -1. At x = -1. That means p(-1). I told you, in the polynomial, wherever x is there, you replace by -1. That is equal to p(-1) = 5 × -1 - 4 × -1² + 3. Clear? That is equal to 5 × -1 means -5. -1² = +1. Any negative numbers, even power is coming, then it will become positive. So -1² how much coming? +1. So +1 × -1. If you want to write one more step, you can write 4 × 1 + 3. Okay, clear? That is equal to -5. Then -4 × 1, that means -4 + 3. Okay, -5 - 4 how much coming? -9 + 3, that is equal to -6. You got the answer is -6. Clear? So now we can find out the next question. Next part of the question: at x = 2. At x = 2. Okay. p(2) = I told you, in the place of x, apply 2. So 5 × 2 - 4 × 2² + 3. Can you see? That is equal to 5 × 2. 5 × 2 - 4 × 2² = 4 + 3. That is equal to 10 - 16 + 3. So 10 + 3 = 30. 30 - 16 means how much will come? -3. Okay. What is the value of p(2)? p(2) you got as -3. Okay. Copy that. Clear now? So this is the formula. This is the method of finding out the value of any polynomial at x = any of the values 0, -1, 2, or any numbers. Clear? Okay. Move to the next question. What is next question? Next question: two sums I will explain and two sums will be common. Okay. So, first next question is question number 2. Find p(0), p(1), comma p of 2 for each of the polynomial, for each of the following polynomial. Okay, so I will first, which are questions that we want to explain?
First and second, do you know? Okay, no, third and fourth is easy.
So, first one topic P of y is equal to y square minus y plus 1. Okay, this is your polynomial. So, what do you want to find out? You want to find out P of 0. And P of 1 and P of 2. So P of 0 we can find out. P of 0 is equal to 0 square minus 0 plus 1. Wherever y is there, there all you apply the value 0. Okay? That is equal to 0 minus 0 plus 1. That means P of 0 is equal to 1. So you got P of 0 here. And now what is the question? P of 1 find out. P of 1 is equal to, here y, here all in the place of y, what will apply? 1. So P of 1 is equal to 1 square minus 1 plus 1. 1 in the place of y, 1. Here also y, 1. And here the same. 1 square, how much coming? 1 minus 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1 will cancel. Then what is the answer coming? 1. So P of 1 is equal to 1. You got the value of P of 1 is equal to how much? 1. Clear? Next question. P, what if you want to find out P of 2? P of 2 is equal to, apply again, 2 square minus 2 plus 1. So 2 square how much? 4 minus 2 plus 1. Okay. So 4 plus 1 how much coming? 5. 5 minus 2? 5 minus 2. Therefore P of 2 how much got? 5 minus 2 how much? 3. So P of 2 is equal. Okay. Clear now the question? Okay. You copy this also. Now next question is that I will explain the second sum. The third and fourth is homework. Okay. We will start the second sum. Question number 2. Right. Listen. P of t is equal to 2 plus t plus 2t square minus t. This is your question. P of t is equal to 2 plus t square minus t. So apply here again start. P of 0 find out. P of 0 is equal to wherever t is there here. Here which is the variable in bracket, what is written, that is the variable. In bracket the t written, the meaning is that t is the variable. Bracket y written, y is the variable. Bracket x writing, x is the variable. Here t is written, so what is the variable t? So where all t in the place of t, all you will replace by 0. 2 plus 0 plus 2 into 0 square minus 0 cube. That is equal to 2 plus 0. 0 square into 2 means 0. 0 cube also 0. Therefore, what you are getting the answer? 2. So, you got the value of P of 0 how much? 2. P of 0 you got as 2. Clear now? And same if I not P of 1. P of 1 is equal to 2 plus in the place of T 1. In the place of T again 1 give 2 into 1 square. In the place of T again 1 give. Okay, can see now? Yes. 2 plus 1. 1 square is 1. 1 into 2, 2. Minus 1 cube is 1. So this plus 1 and this minus 1 will cancel. So 2 plus 2, how much coming? 4. So you got the answer. P of 1 also you got as 4. Clear? And now next question is that P of 2. P of 2 is equal to, again apply 2 plus in the place of t you apply 2 2 again plus in the place of 2t square 2 into 2 square minus 2 cube. Okay. Yes. 2 plus 2 plus 2 into 4 minus 8. That is 2 plus 2 plus. This is 2 square 4. 4 into 2 8. 8 minus 8. So what is 8 minus 8 cancel? So what do you have to say? Answer coming 4. B of 2 is equal to how much coming? 4. B of 2 is equal to 4. Okay. This is the method of finding out the value of any polynomials. Clear? Okay. Move to the next question now. Now, next question. Question number 3. Verify whether the zeros of, whether the following are zeros of the polynomial indicated against them. So each polynomial side some values written. You verify these are the zeros or not. So I already explained and given zeros, how finding out when in the place of x you are putting one value, then the value p of that value is zero coming, then we can say that that value is the zero of the polynomial. Once more I will explain on the board. Listen, students. So verify whether the following zero. So first I will give you the method. See here. I have written a question. B of x is equal to x plus 1. Okay. And here I have written the value as minus 1. So I told you the zero of 1, how checking? This x is equal to minus 1. If you are applying here, so I am going to apply. So B of minus 1 is equal to minus 1 plus 1. You got zero now. Okay, so P of that value 0 coming, make it clear, P of that particular value 0 coming, then what you can say, this x is equal to minus 1 is 0 of the polynomial. This number 0 and this word meaning 0, both are different. This is 0 of the polynomial. I told you 0 of the polynomial can be any number. Sometimes P of minus 2 is 0. Sometimes p of 3 is 0. Sometimes p of 5 is 0. So 2, 5 are the zeros of the polynomial. And this is the our number 0. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, say no, that number is 0. Both are different meaning. Clear. So we can start. Third question. All of you take your textbook and read the third question. So first question, what is given? First question. I will write here, first question is given as P of x is equal to 3x plus 1. And in the side, what is written? X is equal to minus 1 by 3. Given. So I am going to verify if it is 0 of the polynomial or not. So here you can see P of minus 3, I am going to check P of minus 3 is equal to. In the place of x, you apply to minus 3. 3 into minus 1 by 3. Plus 1. So this 3 and this 3 will cancel now. So then what will get? Minus 1 plus 1. So what is minus 1 plus 1? 0. So P of minus 1 by 3, how much you got? P of minus 1 by 3, you got as 0. Therefore, this minus 1 by 3, x is equal to minus 1 by 3, is a 0 of the polynomial. Are you got clear the sum? Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of the polynomial. 0 of the polynomial. One question, I think this is only the method. Is checking is it a 0 of the polynomial. Okay. So, minus 1 by 3 I applied and I got the value as p of minus 1 by 3 is 0. So what is the conclusion you will write? Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of the polynomial. Okay, got clear now? Now, next question. Next, here total 8 sums are there. So in that easy sums, you do homework. And easy, which is difficult for you, I will explain. So, you do second and third homework group. Sorry, second I will explain. Okay, second I will explain. Third do homework, second listen. Question number second. I will write on the board, it is the homework. Question the homework. Question number third section. third okay third section third sampoorna and now second only we are going to do second question is that p of x is equal to 5x minus 5 so what's the value given here x is given as so 5 sorry x is equal to 4 by 5 x is equal to how much given x is given as 4 by 5 clear so we are going to make the easiest of problems we can say p of 4 by 5 is equal to 5 into in the place of x you apply the value so what's the value of x 4 by 5 4 by 5 minus 5 so this 5 and this 5 will cancel out so what will give 4 minus 5 so p of 4 by 5 you got as 4 minus 5 is it zero is never becoming zero the value of 5 how much coming 22 by 7 only coming so it is never cancelling so 4 minus 5 is not equal to 0 therefore can you say x is equal to 4 by 5 is a 0 are you got the meaning so 4 by 5 is not a 0 therefore conclusion is x is equal to 4 by 5 is not a 0 of the polynomial of the polynomial okay zero of the polynomial not a zero of the polynomial both the cases I explained so throughout the sums this is only the method okay now question number second I explained I given the homework now fourth question listen question number four listen question number 4 p of x is equal to x plus 1 into x minus 2 inside written the values x is minus 1 and 2 two values given okay here in the form of factors given then also no problem method is same so we can say at x is equal to 1 say at x is equal to minus 1 so p of minus 1 is equal to minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1 minus 2 wherever x is there they are all apply x is equal to minus 1 so x minus 1 here given here minus 1 given here minus 1 okay so there is equal to minus 1 plus 1 how much comes 0 into minus 1 minus 2 same sign coming so add it and put the same sign so minus 1 minus 2 how much comes minus 1 so what is your answer 0 into any big number multiplying you are getting the answer is 0 so what you got here p of minus 1 how much got p of minus 1 0 got now therefore minus 1 is a 0 of the polynomial therefore minus 1 is a 0 of the polynomial clear now you want to verify one more point 2 so that I will explain here you are saying p of 2 is equal to 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 2 see here your polynomial is p of x is equal to x plus 1 into x minus 2 in the place of x 2 we are applying 2 p of 2 into 2 into 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 2 that only I written here So that is equal to 2 plus 1 how much coming 3 into 0 what is answer got 0 so you got p of 2 is equal to 0 what no okay therefore what you can say 2 is also a 0 of the polynomial 2 is also a 0 of the okay got clear
clear now Now, question number 5 again homework. Okay, fifth question also homework. I will write here fifth sum also. And now we will move to the sixth sum. Question number 6.
Same section. Question number 6.
Listen, question number 6. Listen.
sixth question. P of x is equal to lxa plus m, where x is equal to minus m by n.
Okay, are you got clear?
Same method. So what is the value here given? X is equal to minus m by n. So I am going to apply P of minus m by l is equal to, in the place of x, what I given? Minus m by l. So l into minus m by l plus m. This l cancelling. So minus m plus m. That is equal to how much? What's zero? P of minus m by l is equal to how much? Zero. Therefore, what you can say? X is equal to minus m by l is a zero of the polynomial. Zero of the Okay,
any doubts? So copies. So now in this section, how many sums are remaining? 7 and 8 also remaining. Okay, 7 and 8 sums are remaining. So that sums we will explain on tomorrow. Okay, bye. So properly work out all the sums, and properly you are studying. Maths is very easy subject also. Okay, bye.